5 minutes ago I was considered a hero and people would be clapping and glad that I was doing what I was doing. And then the video came out and I was summarily fired for appearing in what was told to me is an embarrassing video. So that's what happened.
Leaving aside the legal question of whether an employer is just allowed to fire someone for appearing in a video that might hurt the Biden campaign, I'm interested in what their justification was. You're a doctor treating patients in an emergency room. What does a video have to do with your work?
Yeah, of course it has nothing to do with my work. I'm very well liked, well regarded. Thankfully, I've got a wonderful reputation with the patients, with my staff, with my colleagues, and I actually enjoy what I do. But you know, we came to Washington because we're so distressed. You know, frontline doctors like myself, we're seeing patients not get what they need. We're seeing the doctor-patient relationship being completely eroded, that the governors are empowering pharmacies to overrule doctors who've had conversations with their patients. It's really something that America should be alarmed about.
Exactly.
And as you probably know, I did not know things were going to go viral. Of course, I was told later that we were the most viral video of all time. Apparently, there was 18 million views on Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, wherever it is, and they all kind of summarily pulled all of it. It was just all taken off. My own website was taken down, and it's been interesting ever since.
And we should say for our viewers who haven't seen it, and presumably our viewers can't see it because the tech companies have censored it, but it wasn't an hour-long video on hydroxychloroquine. There are many parts to it, including what you just said, that were interesting, that were clearly true. Shouldn't you, as a practicing physician with a medical degree, be allowed to express your views on science as you practice it without being censored?
You know, what's funny is the video that got the most attention was a press conference we did right in front of the Supreme Court, but actually the summit was 7 hours of doctors teaching the American people. We decided to come straight to the American people with lots of social media, so we did a morning session for 3.5 hours and an afternoon session for 3.5 hours. I'm not sure you even knew that, and we went through everything, the lockdown, masks, hydroxychloroquine treatment, other treatments, just all of it, how it affects older people, younger people, etc. That was actually the majority of the summit, and yes, people will be able to find it on, I had to rebuild my website really quickly. America's Frontline Doctors, they took my URL, so it's got the word summit now, America's Frontline Doctors Summit.com. I don't want anyone to just believe me because I'm saying it. We put together a white paper that has all the science. It's utterly irrefutable that hydroxychloroquine is safe. That's without question. And there's tons and tons of studies to show now that it's quite efficacious. You have to kind of wonder why we're still talking about an FDA-approved medication. It's been around for 65 years. It's been around since long before George Washington gave it to his troops. Why are we still discussing it? It's a little bit strange.
Yeah, I mean, look, I majored in Russian history. I don't know anything about hydroxychloroquine. I do know about the way the country's supposed to work. And physicians should be allowed to explain their experiences, their clinical experiences treating patients. And you're not allowed to because Joe Biden getting elected is more important. And that's scary. And I'm grateful that you came on tonight, Dr.
May I say one thing? There's a lot of people saying some negative things about me. I would ask people, please, to stop saying negative things about me. I'm a board-certified emergency physician. I take good care of patients. We've hired Lynn Wood to help me in this matter, and I hope that puts to rest anything that people might want to say that's defamatory.
I hope so, too. I rarely root for lawyers, but I am in this case. Dr. Wood, thank you. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
There it is.
If you watch the show repeatedly over the years, we